Okay, are you guys ready for this? Let's say the user starts and they go to addons.mozilla. We have the choice. It's not a choice, but the browser will know if they're authenticated or not. If they're not authenticated, we will. If they are authenticated, we'll know if they've migrated or not. So we'll be able to show two states, and those states will look something like this. One will be the error, you already have an error format, and it'll say add-ons to switching to Firefox accounts for login, sign in now to transfer your account. If they've already migrated, they're signed in, they'll just see the regular account. Subtle difference here is we have one that's a username, the other one is, let's say, the email address. That may not be the way we show it, but anyway, that's the way we indicated here. So here's where it gets hairy. We're going to go back to the start, and if they are unauthenticated, it will say, oh, add-ons are switching to Firefox accounts for login. You know what? And the user may just ignore that, whatever. Maybe they close it, I don't know. But whether they click register or login, they're going to get much the same experience, which is give us your email address. This is instead of putting two sign-in options on the page, which I just do not think works. I think it's only going to cause problems. So the user then has to enter their email address and hit next. They can also toggle if they go, oh yeah, wait, no, I have one, I don't know. And users always met, like, we get a lot of Firefox accounts, people who register, who think they're signing in, so you kind of have to always handle both. So luckily the case is identical for both. So are you ready for this? Let's continue. So if the user has an existing AMO account that was not migrated, it's still in there, we can pre-populate that form with their email address. And if it's successful, we can say to them, Mozilla add-ons has transitioned to Firefox accounts for login. Continue to complete the simple upgrade process. So from there, they have the option to continue or skip. Ignore that weirdo line. I don't know what that is. If they say skip, I don't want to do this now. Then they're just going to see this annoying message again. Now, if they don't say skip and they say continue, the system will know if that email address is associated with a Firefox account. So if they don't have a Firefox account, it will say create a Firefox account, continue to Mozilla add-ons. If they have a different account with a different email, we can put a special message up here. It's the same as the bottom, but we want to let them know that they can use a different, we don't want them creating multiple Firefox accounts, so we want them to just have one, so they can click sign in, and then they'll go to the sign in form, which is if they had clicked sign in originally, they would go here and sign in, and so then if that's successful and they're migrating, what they get is a little message that'll say, great job, you can now log in out on the Firefox account. Or the AMO, and the AMO account is, I said deleted, I don't know what you want to call it, but retired. But basically what happens when you do the check the next time, it is, and we'll follow the red line here, the user goes to log in, it knows with their email address that there is no longer an AMO, and they have a Firefox account, so they sign in and they're in. So that is the goal here. One caveat, I think, in this last step is that we might want to show settings, and I'll let the user put their avatar in and set their display name or whatever it is. Anyway, that was this pass. This is the more deluxe approach called email funnel. As you can see, it's a lot more complicated. I think it is a better user experience, so I'm going to leave that in.